Okay, so this is the review, the 02 review for handout 7 and 8. So right now we're setting up a document here. I'll take facing pages off, and you can see my margins are a half an inch. So when I say OK, those pink lines are my half inch margins. Now, the first question on the review is, how do you change the margins on your document once you've opened it and already set them? So the answer is you need to go to the Layout menu, and you need to go to Margins and Columns, and here they are. This one's highlighted. I'll change it to 1, and if I tab, it fills in the inches for me in all of them because this icon is pressed in, which means change 1, change all. It's the link is unbroken, so they all change together. So I will say OK. Number 2, a fast way to select a field when using a dialog box, for example, when changing the top margin. So I'm going to come back into this dialog box. If I only want to change one margin and not all of them, I need to take that off. So now the link is broken. And a fast way to do it is just to click on the word, and then it's selected. You can immediately type and just enter, and you can see that that top margin only has now changed. Number 3, hold this key to increase the increments displayed when using the up or down arrow in a field box. So, for example, right now we'll go back in here. So you can see that when I go up, I am jumping up in who knows what decimal that is. I'm actually going to set it back to 1. And just tab, and then I'm going to come back to it and just see what I have now. So it's going up. I don't know what these increments are, if it's thirds or whatever. So I'm going to say OK, and then I'm going to come in here into Preferences and Units and Increments, and right here, Increments, this is probably a better example right here. I'm going to give you a better example. Is that I'm going to put some text on here. So here's a text box. My text right now is 12 points. I'm going to select it. And each time I click this, it's going up 1 point at a time. And that's, I'm a little surprised because that setting is supposed to be based on this. And it says 2 points. And so I am going to come in here because now I'm curious. And I'm going to come to my character panel. I'm going to select this. And I'm going to go up. And it is going up 1 point at a time. But there are days when, if we want it to go up 1 point at a time, we need to come in here and tell it that we want it to go up 1 point at a time. So I'll change that. So if you are having trouble getting it to go 1 point at a time, you would go into your Edit Preferences menu. But the other thing is that when you hold Shift and click on an up arrow, that takes it up in increments of 10, you can see. So pressing and holding Shift when you're going up or down will increase the increments displayed, which is the answer that belongs in 3, is use Shift. When you see a plus sign near the bottom right of text, you know that there is, so let's do that. I'm just going to take this text box. I am going to get into my type tool and just fill it with placeholder text. And then, if my text box is smaller, you can see I get the plus sign. And so question number four, the answer is, when you see that plus sign in the out port, you know that there is overset text. So there's more text than can fit in this box. So you either need to make another text box and thread it, or you need to make this bigger until it all fits. Question five, the command file place brings in the text from a text file into a text container. The shortcut is, so let's just make another container here. And the shortcut is Control D. That's your place file. And it looks like I have some text here. I'll just bring in something that looks like it's fairly big. I have no idea what's in that one. And say OK. So there actually is some more in here because I can see the plus, but where it is, I'm not exactly sure. But the Control D is the file place shortcut. That's the keyboard shortcut. Number six, this icon found on the menu bar after the words. So if you look up on the menu bar, here's the words. And after the words, somewhere around the middle, is this icon. And it's called screen mode. It can also be accessed through the menu view screen mode. So for example, if we click on this and we go to preview, it takes our margins away and shows us what it looks like without any of the text frames. Come back to normal, the text frames and margins are back. The shortcut for that is W, gets you into preview, and W toggles you back to normal. Question 7. The five screen modes available are, it says normal, preview, bleed, slug, and this one. And the fifth one is this one, presentation. And when you click that mode, it's going to be the mode that you might like to use if you were presenting something to a client. It takes all the software tools away and just shows you exactly what the document will look like. And I can just escape to get out of presentation mode. Question 8. Preview mode shows only what will print on the page. The toggle keyboard shortcut is W. We've done that one. 9. Presentation mode shows only the page, so you don't see any InDesign tools. The keyboard shortcut is Shift W. 10. Use this key to get out of presentation mode. I just use Escape. 11. The screen mode we usually work in is normal. Number 12. The file place command gives us a cursor called, it's called the loaded text cursor. So if we go and bring in a text file and say open, there is our loaded text cursor right there. And I'm going to just press Escape to get out of there. If you want to place text from Word files that have formatting, like line breaks and blank lines, then click this checkbox in the File Place dialog box. So let's go back into the command with Control D. And if I bring in this file, and if I put a check beside this box, Show Import Options, when I click open, I get a second box, and that will allow me, and now this is old wording, extra carriage. A carriage was on a typewriter, and you had a big handle, and you had to push it, but the modern equivalent would be the enter key. So remove any return, any hard return, any enter at the end of every line, and remove them between paragraphs. Because when we go to format our text later, doing this will save us a lot of work. Just take them all out and then we will format it the way that we like. So when I say OK and I place this, you can see there's no lines between paragraphs. It just brings it all in as raw text without the formatting. Number 14 says, when you do what you said in 13, when you click Show Import Options, when you put the check beside that box, it brings up a second box where you can ask to have the extra carriage returns and blank lines removed. That is true. 15, a text frame that has overset text has a box, and that box is called an outport, with a plus sign on it. The box is called an outport. 16, if you have a loaded text cursor and you want to change the cursor to a regular cursor, click here. You can just click on the select tool to get rid of it. You just saw that I just did that. Control D, pick a file, I said open, I said okay, and then, oops, I made a mistake. How do I get out of this? I find escape, but you can also just go and click on the select tool and that loaded text cursor will be gone. So escape or select tool. 17, clicking view show text threads automatically shows the links between all linked frames. So that is true. So if we have a box and we have, we'll just make another text frame and then we'll go and click on that plus. First you have to have the frame selected. That's why I didn't get the cursor, but the second time that I clicked it, now it's ready to, and you can see I still have more. But if I go to view, extras, show text threads, you can see that this line is showing that the text is being threaded from this text box to this text box, and if I had another one, it would then go to that text box if we threaded it. Like so.